Yeah, your boy GP the Beast, man. Shout out that gang. Fill his pocket up with some chain. I just want to talk to him. Tried to smut my name. But niggas know I'm about it.
I'm about it.
And what fucked me up is the niggas that spoke about
niggas
it.
Who spoke
niggas
about
didn't even
it.
Defend me. They don't know I know about it.
They don't know.
What really fucked me up, the hater side was the most crowded. Shout it out. What's up? It's your boy GP the Beast, man, and I'm back. I got some more heat for your ass. You know what I'm talking about? This time we in CMC, state prison. You know what I mean? A lot of y'all might be familiar with that. We're going to touch on that 2017 riot, the blacks against the Mexicans. GP the Beast was on the yard. GP the Beast was in the building. GP the Beast had to get active one more time. This was on my last bit too, so this wasn't too long ago. Anyway, tune in, man. This shit about to go crazy.
With a deadly riot at the California Men's Colony in San Luis Obispo. KSBY News reporter Alexa Bertola explains what happened.
Kelsey, it's a much different scene out here this evening, much quieter than it was just several hours ago when more than 150 inmates rioted. Tonight, one inmate is dead and eight others are injured.
Chaos at the California Men's Colony. One ambulance after another rushed inmates to the hospital. A massive riot broke out at a yard in the East facility. With more than 160 inmates involved in the melee, CMC correctional officers used 40-millimeter less than lethal rounds and chemicals to try to bring the chaos under control. None of the staffers were hurt. Nine inmates were stabbed.
When we call a mass casualty incident, we call for all hands on deck.
Several had critical wounds.
Our trauma surgeon did request that the OR crew come and be here on standby.
One inmate died at the hospital. CMC staff say that man was 25-year-old Matthew Cook. He was serving nearly 14 years for several counts of first-degree burglary. As for the reason behind the riot turned deadly, that will be looked into in the days to come.
Yeah, that was Matthew Cook. He was a white boy Crip, but he was fucking with the blacks. So when they killed him, they killed one of ours. So they won that war that day. Because, sad to say, Matthew misjudged the situation. Technically, he didn't even have enough points to be there. You see, in prison, right, inmates really be tripping off real estate. And that was the year that they had started letting all the Mexicans out of the hole who had been in the hole. So they had made CMC a good yard. It became a good yard for Mexicans because one of their OG shot callers had got released from the hole and they put him in CMC. Now, what I say about they be tripping off real estate. Now, of course, they hadn't really had no weight pal. They hadn't had no section. They created a section. They had created a little bench on the side, and they was getting deeper and deeper. I knew that while they was getting deeper and deeper, it was soon going to be an issue. Although I fuck with the Mexicans, you know, I like how they function. I like how they structure, but they be on some manly shit. You know what I'm talking about? And when they want something, they tripping. Well, they wanted a weight pal. And they wanted a big section of it. And they was tripping. And it had been meetings about it all day. Repeatedly.
And the California Men's Colony is under lockdown at this hour. We're told that can remain in effect for the next several days. In San Luis Obispo, Alexa Bertola, KSBY News.
California Men's Colony houses more than 4,100 inmates, both minimum and medium security. And as Alexa reported, there are two facilities at the prison. The West facility on your right houses minimum security inmates. It offers camps for the fire suppression, conservation, and community service projects. But the riot broke out at the yard of East facility there on your left. That's where the medium security inmates are housed. The East facility also has a hospital and mental health unit. Because of all the treatment programs and job training offered at the complex, inmates sometimes refer to CMC as the country club of prisons.
I don't know what part of the prison they talking about, but that motherfucker sure wasn't no country club. You know what I'm talking about? That motherfucker was active and it was getting busy. and niggas end up dying on this motherfucking day. Let me tell you how the morning started. So it was the weekend, Saturday morning. You know, I fucks with the weekend hella tough, cause I fucks with the sports and I run the ticket in the prison. So every weekend, I'm going to get about a gallon, maybe 2 gallons of wine, and we gonna fuck with it, watch sports, do the tickets, make this money. You know what I'm saying? So we up there, we done got our shit. I go out to go get my drink, and hella niggas is grouped up. I'm like, why is shit looking spooky around here? Shit ain't looking right. Bro, that's with me. He like, yeah, I'm seeing it too. I'm like, niggas is grouping up. What's going on? So we find out, you know, the Mexicans, you know, is tripping a little bit. You know, they want to fuck with the, they want their weight power. They want their property, man. They want their real estate. So niggas is talking about it. I'm not really indulging too much. I'm really trying to get the fuck home. They gave me 17 years on this shit. Nigga, I done got old in the motherfucker. I'm not trying to be hella active. I'm not trying to be frontline and shit. I'm really trying to kick back, man, and get the fuck up out of here, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? This shit bad for me. 17 was fucking with me and killing me right now, nigga. So I'm really trying to do all the right shit to change my life. So, but I see the shit going on. I'm out there, though, nigga. If it do go crazy, I'm finna do what I do. It's cool though, it kind of like mellowed down. I get to drink, we go back up in the building. We go up in the building, we up in the day room. We watching the TV, you know, I'm watching the game, see if I'm winning or losing, see if I'm winning or losing, because it's me against the whole prison. I run the ticket in the whole prison. So it's me against the whole prison. You know what I'm saying? This is what I do, I'm killing them like that, right? So yeah, we fucking with it, and we in the day room drinking. All of a sudden, we like, niggas is out there fighting, bro. Look. Niggas is out there going crazy. It's the niggas against the white boys. Niggas is knocking white boys out, though. They running through them niggas, right? We like, oh, what is that? Is that the Mexicans? Because we know if it's the Mexicans, we better get on point for real, for real. We like, oh, it was the white boys. So we weren't really tripping. Only because they wasn't that deep.
About that.
It was a white boy that just sold us motherfucking two motherfucking gallons of wine next door, and the nigga hadn't got his money, and he seen it out his window that was going down. We try to go back over there because we know the nigga got some more wine. We trying to get the rest of this wine because we know now it's finna be locked down. Bruh, this nigga locked the dough. He don't even want his money, nigga. That nigga locked his dough and was like, nigga, it's good. I'm not doing nothing. That nigga turned the lights out. Nigga blacked out on us. You know what I'm talking about? Anyway, nigga, we fucking with it and we drink it. We see the shit, the alarm go down and shit. You know what I mean? They lay down and shit. Everybody lay down like we good, nigga. You know what I'm saying? We good. So we up in there still drinking and blowing. All of a sudden, we like, bruh, look at the white boys. What, nigga, they just getting up. Nigga, they like, fuck the alarm, nigga. Fuck the police, nigga. They getting up. The niggas over there hella deep, nigga. They still sitting down and shit. The white boys then got up. They talking and shit amongst each other. They plotting some shit. All of a sudden, nigga, they start walking towards the Mexicans. The Mexicans hella deep over there. You know what I'm saying? They on the way pal where they been working out at. They damn near then took it over anyway. They just want the signature to say it's theirs. The white boys start walking over there to them. We like, what the fuck going on? What they doing? Mind you, we still in the day room. The alarm done went off. They done laid the yard down. The brothers is still sitting all over there in their area. The white boys was way over here, but they was laid down and prone out, but they got up. But they done walked all the way to the Mexicans, which is over like in the middle of the yard by the wall. All of a sudden, they talking. We like, what the fuck going on? The white boys is telling them, nigga, why y'all didn't help us? We supposed to be aligned with each other. We supposed to be fucking with each other. But y'all just let the black smash on us and y'all didn't even help us? I don't know what else that nigga said, but all of a sudden the Mexicans looked at the blacks who were still sitting down and they took off. Nigga, straight towards all the blacks. Craziest shit I ever seen. It went up. With the whites and the Mexicans combined, it had to be about 500 to 700 people. And they was all coming at the blacks who was all sitting down and proned out. So their immediate reaction was to jump up and go in the building for security to secure theyself. And they did that. Of course, I was confused at first because my mindset was like, attack them motherfuckers. I think we could have took them, but they did what they did. But once they got in the building, I noticed they didn't go all the way up in there. Some did, some didn't, but the majority of them got stopped at impact. Instead of going in, some of them start coming out, and they did end up coming out, which left the building all by itself. And whatever was on the yard, they attacked. And whatever was in the building, it was a domino effect. It set it all off. Each building set off a war between the Mexicans, the blacks, and the whites. Like I had said, it was the weekend. And on the weekends, we kind of just kick back and fuck with it. We'd be on alert, but every car pretty much going to have a drink. You know, they're going to smoke. You know, if they get high, they're going to get high. They're going to be more relaxed. But this weekend was a little bit different. This weekend, niggas was tripping. Niggas was on edge. And, you know, the white boy Crip, he was doing his thing. He wasn't outside the building, so he wasn't aware of what was going on. The prisons be so big that a lot of times, we be inside the building. And we be doing our shit, you know. We might be playing chess. We might be drinking, watching a game on TV. Because one thing about CMC, that motherfucker had ESPN 1 and 2. That motherfucker had all the sports channels. And it's the weekend. And niggas is betting like a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I'm taking in like $200-$300 a day. I'm running the whole ticket. So I'm saying that to say this. White boy Crip was up in there kicking it. He was drinking. He was smoking. He was doing his thing. You know, having fun. We fuck with it. It ain't all bad for us. You know, we get high. We kick it. We fuck with it. We want to party. You know what I'm saying? Weekends is like our party days. Because every day, Monday through Friday, them motherfuckers in that prison got your ass going to work. You're going to get up and go to work somewhere. It's only 1% of motherfuckers in prison that figure out a way how to wiggle out of work. So Monday through Friday, your ass is getting up. You up at 4 o'clock in the morning because breakfast is at 4:30 or 5. And if you miss it, you miss it. That's it. And if you miss breakfast, you miss lunch. Because when you go get breakfast, that's when they give you your lunch. So if you miss breakfast, you miss lunch. And you'll be a hungry motherfucker all the way till 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, at night, 7 o'clock, depending on how long they take to feed a nigga. And then when you get there, the food gonna be garbage. I'm talking about garbage. I used to only go to try to get to chicken or something. You got some chicken on the plate? Let me get that. Oh, you got a hamburger today? Yeah, I'm going to fuck with that. You know what I'm talking about? But other than that, nigga, I'm not up there, man. That shit up there, garbage. You know, in prison, we learn how to cook our own shit. We cook our own shit. You know what I'm saying? We take shit from a boiler, take the hot pot off. Whatever was making that boiler hot, we finna turn that motherfucker into a stove so we can cook and heat some shit up. But anyway, let's get back to the story. He was slipping because he was in there having fun and he had no knowledge that the war had started. I don't know if he got back comfortable after the blacks and the white boys, they laid it down. Usually shit like that happened. Once you lay it down, it's usually over. But on this particular situation, the white boys got back up. Now see, I wasn't in his building, so I can't tell you detail from detail exactly how white boy Crip lost his life. From what I heard, and I usually get pretty good information, from what I heard, he noticed the commotion and niggas was tripping and he was already on. He had been drinking. He had been smoking. I don't know if he was high on anything else. I don't know. But he seen the commotion. And just like a thug and a gang-banging ass nigga, he reacted. Nigga, ooh, what's happening? Oh, niggas is tripping? And he ran up on a nigga to try to knock him out. But that motherfucking Mexican pulled out a motherfucking thing this motherfucking big and stuck it all through him and kept sticking him and kept sticking him. And he killed him. Niggas couldn't stop it. But don't get it fucked up. Niggas was on the Mexicans, fucking them up. They got fucked up. I mean, they was being carted out that motherfucker like a motherfucker on dollies. Yeah. I'm surprised it wasn't more body bags because niggas was getting fucked up. Like I said, it was a domino effect. I can't tell you everything that happened in the mother buildings, but what I can tell you is what happened in mine. So I was in my building. I had got so caught up on watching the shit from the window that it hadn't hit me. That nigga, we into it with the white boys and the Mexicans now. Nigga, you better get your shit. So I immediately snap into a killer mode like, nigga, hold on, bruh. Let me go get strapped, nigga. So I'm going in the hallway. Now, mind you, before all this happened, the Mexicans had already been on the tier. We had been in the day room. My door was locked, so I couldn't get in my room. When the white boys had got into it with the blacks the first time, the police had came and locked the gate. But he didn't lock the day room door, which means the hallway and the day room door were all open. And the Mexicans were still on the tier with their door open to their room, which means they had access at their knives to come kill us. And we had access at nothing except this mop I found in this motherfucking day room. Now, although me and the Mexicans and the blacks, we can kick it, we be fucking with it, the minute it's wartime, it's business. And the business is to kill. And they have no choice. If they don't, then they will get killed. So they automatically got to attack us. So I was going into the day room. And I said, I'm finna go get my knife. And I remember the big L.A. Crip nigga. I forgot my nigga name. That nigga was like, nah, GP. And this other nigga from Bakersfield, nah, don't go out there, bro. Don't go out there. I'm like, nigga, my room, my door right there. I'm finna, don't go out there. And while I'm going out there, I see the Mexicans. They looking at me. They coming. And they got that look like, nigga, we ain't got no choice, bro. We got to get you. Ooh, bro, I'm trapped. Nigga, we trapped. We trapped in this little ass room. This little room right here in the day room, and the door is open. And these niggas is coming. They like, come back up in here. And I said, oh, my mama, I ain't got no choice. I'm coming up in here. And nigga, on my mama, I'm going to do everything possible to not let these niggas get up in here and kill us. Every time I go to prison, I always feel like the main thing about prison is to be able to get out. When I got my first 10 years, I came back from court, and it was this OG in the pod, and he said, what they give you? I said, man, they gave me 10 years. I said, man, I can't do no 10 years. He looked down at me. He said, yes, you can. All you got to do is keep going to sleep and keep waking up. And as long as you keep waking up, your day gonna come. I didn't really understand the significance of it At first, I thought he meant all I had to do was just keep going to sleep and keep waking up. But I realized he meant that. Make it possible for you to keep going to sleep every night while you in this motherfucker, and damn sure make it possible for you to wake up. Because if you don't wake up, that means you ain't make it.
I think you can
make it. It was bad. Them niggas was coming down the hallway, and nigga, we was stuck in this little ass room. I immediately looked around. Nigga, what can I find? What could I use? Nigga, I seen the broom, and I seen the mop. The mop's handle was skinnier than the broom, so I grabbed the broom. I quickly laid it on the side of the bench. The bench was made out of cement, so it was up. I laid it on the bench and the floor, and I kicked that motherfucker. Pow! And broke it. Nigga, it gave me a motherfucking weapon. They had the little tables, the little metal-looking tables and shit. Nigga, you jump, nigga, with the round part and the bench. Nigga, I jumped on the top of that motherfucker, nigga, and waited by the door, nigga. Soon as they come in, nigga, the first nigga they gonna see is me, nigga. I got that motherfucking broom, nigga, and that motherfucking handle is fat. Nigga, soon as the nigga came in, pow, nigga, pow! All headshots, nigga. Pow! The nigga was still coming in, though. He didn't give a fuck. Man, them motherfucking Mexicans, nigga. They take a licking and keep on ticking. This nigga was taking a beat, trying to get up in there, though, nigga. Pow! He back up. Other nigga try to come in. Pow, nigga. Pow! One time, nigga, I ain't gonna even lie. I swung this motherfucker. The nigga grabbed it. I said, oh, shit. I done fucked up. Nigga, we like tug of war, nigga. We like tug of war, nigga. I'm on the table, though. So the nigga face right here, nigga, I got my knee. We like tug of war, and I'm like, pow! Hit that nigga with my knee. That nigga let go. I got that motherfucker back, and I'm back in control. Pow! Pow! So I'm beating this nigga, right? This nigga get pulled back. So this nigga, it's about three or four of them, though. They trying to get in. The other ones get in. But nigga, the big homie nigga from L.A., nigga, the big youngster nigga, he smacking shit. Bow! Nigga, he really smacking shit. Bow! And this nigga from Bakersfield, this nigga, they coming in. Boop, boop, boop. These niggas really smacking shit. I'm like, okay. Nigga, look at these niggas. These niggas getting down. But we got to, though. These niggas is trying to kill us. Now, it's two more niggas in there, but nigga, they really can't get involved because it's me. I'm at the front, nigga. I'm at the door, and I'm on the motherfucking table, and then it's the big L.A. Crip, nigga, and then it's the Bakersfield, nigga. The Bakersfield, nigga, buffing a motherfucker, but nigga, we ain't letting nothing get in, and we so vicious, nigga, the crazy nigga. I'm smacking this nigga, blood coming all out this nigga face. Blah! Nigga, I grab that nigga. I try to grab that nigga up in here. You want to keep coming up in here? Okay, nigga, we gonna kill you, nigga. I'm grabbing this nigga up in here. His homeboys had to grab him by his legs, nigga, and pull him back out. But I'm glad they did, though. Shit, nigga, I would have caught a motherfucking murder. Nigga, saved my life. Anyway, nigga, they grabbed the nigga back out. So these niggas, they just keep coming. And nigga, we just keep beating, trying to keep these niggas from coming in. And then all of the police, come to the gate. He see the shit going on. He like, oh, fuck. Then he run and lick. He go and try to get some spray shit. He come back and try to spray. He spray a little bit. The niggas back up. But the nigga don't really know what to do. But the nigga, he like, back up. And they back up and he spray some more shit. The nigga spray enough and come in, nigga, and the nigga lock the door, nigga, and lock us in, nigga. And nigga, on my mama, nigga, that's how we got saved that day. It was some crazy shit going on, man. Nigga was, boy, I swear to God, this shit just keep happening. This shit just keep happening. Every time a nigga go to the pen, this shit just keep happening. But nigga ain't in the pen no more now. Shit, this shit ain't gonna keep happening no more. We stayed in that cell probably another 9 hours. But we was safe in a motherfucker up in there. And we still had some drink. And we still had some weed. So we just watched the whole thing. We watched them gather everybody up one by one. Handcuff everybody. Line niggas up. Take niggas to the hoe. Take niggas to the hospital. Pull niggas out on gurney. We seen niggas that was fucked up. We even seen Matthew Cook. He came out in a black bag. After it was all over, they locked everything up. They came and put us back in the cell. My neighbor, he was one of the Mexicans that was trying to get in the door to kill me. He said, GP, we had the back window where we could talk to each other. You know, we used to fuck with each other. We fucked with each other. He had my CDs over there. We had passed each other weed when we on lockdown. You know, we fucked with it. I buy a drink from him and shit. He said, GP, it's right after the incident, after they put me in my cell. I said, yeah, what's up, man? He said, man, I got your CDs over here, man. I said, it's good. He said, GP. I said, yeah. He said, bruh, you was fucking my motherfucking homeboy up, man. Man, you was fucking that nigga up. I said, man, that nigga crazy, man. He said, man, I said, that nigga's a real crash dummy. He said, bruh, you was fucking that nigga up. He said, GP, I like you, bruh. You're a real nigga. He said, I just want you to know, don't let this shit come between us. This shit ain't nothing but business. This shit ain't nothing but business. That's it. I fuck with you. Shout it out. And that's what I be telling niggas, bruh. Shit ain't nothing but business. On the street, I fuck with niggas. It don't matter where you from. You a real nigga, I fuck with you. You on some weird shit, I don't fuck with you. Period. But shit, this shit in prison, this shit ain't nothing but business. Okay, so look, man, if you feeling my stories and you feeling this flavor, man, push that bell. Get these notifications so every time I drop something and subscribe. Man, get your boy up to this 10,000. I'm trying to go live for y'all, man. You know what I mean? Support me. Tell a friend. Subscribe. Like. Let me get the like. You know what I'm talking about? And let me get the comments. Let me know what y'all think. You know what I'm saying? For real shit. Let me know what y'all think. You know what I'm saying? I read that shit. I fuck with y'all. Shout it out. Go check out the new Mozzie books on Amazon.com right now.